Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We are live. The gates have opened. The wild bucking bull has been released. We are transmitting worldwide on AM and FM dial, over 100 affiliates, XM channel 166, global shortwave and audio streams at Infowars.com and Prisonplanet.com, as well as the Prisonplanet.tv video streams. And we are going to be here for the next 3 hours at least today. It is the 19th day of January 2012, and the quickening is obviously accelerating. And I've got a trillion different thoughts racing through my mind. I will attempt to control myself today. I will attempt to not explode in rage and anger, but also in exultation in the level of victories we're having against tyranny, but also in disgust at the victories that the control freak criminal gangs are having as well. It is the best of times. It is the worst of times. We have an unbelievable transmission lined up for you. Richard Stallman, free software guru of gurus, will be joining us to talk about SOPA. And a lot more coming up for 30 minutes in the second hour today. Great job to the crew getting that set up. I also want to say great job to all the listeners and all of our affiliates and sponsors. We couldn't do this without you. And it shows every day that there are a lot of good people in this country, and that the majority of people want freedom and have courage, that we could be on over 100 AM and FM stations. I just learned that for over a month we've been on a big station in Albuquerque. I just learned that for over 2 months we've been on another big station in Colorado, another big one in California, and in New York State and Florida. I mean, we're just exploding right now and getting, in some areas, number one in places like Orlando and other major cities. That shows you that the truth is hitting on all cylinders, and people are really ready to wake up and really ready to hear the truth. That is so incredibly exciting. And I will try to live up to the responsibility I've got here. And I know a lot of people have jumped through a lot of hoops to get us on the radio locally in your area. I know that a lot of people have done a lot to sponsor this broadcast and support us over the years, and we owe it all to you, the listeners and supporters out there. You're not behind this show. You are beside this show and in front of this show and all around this broadcast of awakening and understanding. You are the key to all of this. If there's a weak link, it is Alex Jones. And I've got my positive points, but I understand that I'm only human. It is the wisdom of the crowd and of common sense America and people across the world that have verified and supported our information and helped get it out to countless millions. And you are the reason this broadcast and everything we do is strapped on top a giant rocket. I mean, we are having a huge effect. Now, I'm done ranting. We have that big guest on SOPA coming up. We've got the latest on SOPA. We've got unbelievable breaking Ron Paul election 2012 news that is hiding in plain view and that no one is pointing out, that no one is discussing out there, not even on the big Ron Paul sites. And I don't blame them. This just broke in the last hour. I was in here getting ready for the show, and I'd heard some of it on the local news radio we had on in the background and on the TV, but it was Darren McBreen, our reporter, that walked in and said, "Have you seen all these articles?" And I read them, and the spin all came together, and it is so outrageous what they're doing. I'm going to tell you about that in a moment, but it's around Iowa. Then we've got the economic news. Kodak files for bankruptcy protection. U.S. losing high-tech manufacturing jobs to Asia. We've lost more than a quarter. under globalism in just the last few years, Washington Post. This is like a success report card the globalists are putting out. Obama shut down that pipeline that would supply more gasoline, more oil to the United States from Canada. Of course, it'll now just go east, or I guess west in that case, to China, so that they'll get that oil. They already get 80% of the oil that comes out of Alaska. Our own government blocks it. Vampire hedge funds are sucking Greece dry. Just amazing news on that front. We've got some really good news from the Paul camp. Ron Paul has introduced legislation to strike down NDAA's unconstitutional police state sections. This got no attention anywhere. The corporate media, the only attention they gave Ron Paul, because I know I was up all last night on Coast to Coast AM and doing radio interviews this morning, and I was tracking it. Nothing in the news about Ron Paul going back to Washington when the other candidates wouldn't think about it and voting against the debt increase. They reported on that and said it was symbolic and pointless and he's pathetic. They didn't point out all the other stuff he did, like introduce legislation to repeal the secret police, secret arrest, total war, end of habeas corpus, end of the Constitution, NDAA. Radio, TV, print, silence. One guy happened to be watching the C-SPAN back there in the coffee room. His name's Kurt Nemo, and he wrote an article about it in the afternoon yesterday. There was a few articles from the control left, like Huffington Post today, and I commend him for that. But that's big news right there. Ron Paul introduces legislation to strike NDAA's unconstitutional section 1021. That allows the military to operate domestically to black bag citizens. Of course, I think it should be more. Of course, he says he's introducing the bill. It hasn't been introduced yet. Reportedly, that's going to happen today or tomorrow. But hopefully, it'll have the other sections. He just mentioned his bill would have that to not say that the worldwide battlefield without congressional approval, forget a declaration, not even approval, they can kill whoever they want, bomb whoever they want, invade whoever they want, because Obama is the new master of the universe. So you've got all of that happening with almost zero media coverage. Dinosaur, corporate, prostitute, prostitute media. And we're going to be discussing that with, really somebody you could call the father of the free software, free internet movement. The Obi-Wan Kenobi of it, Richard Stallman, will be joining us coming up to talk about SOPA. But you know, something clicked for me last night while I was basically staying up all night. I did take an hour-long cat nap. That's why I'm so energized today. It's just amazing. Google is already using SOPA-like censorship. And I want to break this down later. Google was set up with NSA and CIA money. You can just type that into the NSA search engine Google, and you'll get Washington Post, MIT Magazine. But they're like how cute it is and how sweet sea cake it is and how much fun it is and it's no big deal. And, oh, yeah, the heads of Google go to Bilderberg and on and on and on. So why did Google black out its name on its website yesterday, which was just kind of ceremonial, without even linking to any information to explain what was happening, like Reddit and Infowars.com and Wikipedia did. Very effective what Wikipedia did. I don't realize how much I use Wikipedia, even though it's questionable sometimes because it is open source, as you'd call it. But overall, it's pretty accurate. Sometimes they put in there that I've died or they put disinformation in there about other people, but it gets corrected. And they kind of spin things and don't really have any of our accomplishments on there and cover a bunch of gossip. So overall, it's distorted. But the general info on it, at least in the bibliographies, is very useful. And I realized with Wikipedia blacked out yesterday how much I use it. Of course, I did put in a 22-hour day yesterday, but I probably, without even thinking, was directed there or linked there more than 30 or 40 times. I mean, I quit counting, and it was blacked out. And it was smart how they did it. You'd see the info for about 2 seconds that you were looking for. And of course, I don't just believe what I read on there. I then go check the bibliography and go to the links on the bottom. But it is invaluable. It is the best encyclopedia out there. And of course, it's not 100% accurate. About 95% accurate. from my deep research. That doesn't mean I'm completely accurate either. But the point is, there's a lot of agendas there. But you could see it for about 3 seconds or so, and you'd be start to read the info you wanted, and then boom, it would cut to the black page and say, learn about internet censorship and this SOPA bill that will cripple freedom on the web as we know it, take political action. And Reddit had an effective deal as well. We just put a big banner at the top linking to some basic info about it. That's because we've beat this dead horse over and over again. You know, we've done our job on this front. We don't just do it on one day. We do it every day. But everybody's missing the main enchilada here, the main boat. Why is Yahoo? Why is Google? Why are big globalist firms that are known New World Order, why are they against it? It's an internal fight in the system. Because they don't want a government with ham-fisted people having the power to shut down whatever they want, whenever they want, and blacklist people. Because Google's global, and basically for all intents and purposes, is a large part of the internet. I mean, I'd call it several large organs of the internet. I mean, you take those out, it would really have some issues. And they're tentacled into everything. This is an internal globalist separation of power struggle, something the founders said would hold back tyranny to a certain extent, because they're always battling with each other like two hyenas over a baby gazelle they've already killed, and one's got a leg, one's got the neck, and they're kind of pulling it. One of them runs in and grabs some guts and drags those off into the bushes. Eyeballs are hanging out. So later, and I'm going to break this down, we're going to show you the total proof of Google censoring and doing exactly what SOPA does, like gangbusters on steroids. That's all coming up today. But first, the unbelievable Ron Paul censorship, election fraud, huge scandal going on right now that is getting almost no attention. I mean, it's getting covered, but they're not telling you what's happening.
Did you know that how well your brain works?
Roll. I know you're listening, Dave. I want to say hi. Sorry I'm butchering your great music. Just like the Pied Piper. You know, if you look at the whole Gingrich thing that Drudge broke before ABC News even announced that they were going to air the interview this evening, you've got the ex-wife who she had cancer. And he came to her and divorced her, and then he told one of his top aides, reportedly, this has been out for years, but now she's speaking out, well, she's not good-looking, she's old, she's got cancer, I need a young, good-looking wife to get elected. I mean, even if you and your wife weren't getting along, when they've got cancer or whatever, you take care of them. And it just shows this is a demon. This is a demon. And then he's got this new wife, and she buys like $500,000 worth of jewelry every few months. I mean, it just, and then he writes books about being frugal. That's the thing. If you want to buy $500,000 worth of jewelry every few months for your wife to keep her happy because it's all this lobbyist money you got selling America out, well, that's one thing, traitor. But to write books about it, being frugal and all this garbage when you're a little pimp who likes glitter bug stuff. And most of these globalists, that's how they are. They're into just petty junk. These are such empty little chicken neck jellyfish. And again, I'm not saying things are bad.